y'all know what it is. It's the six order band pass with the VVX12 from Scar Audio. Right now, what we have on the screen is the response line of this. However, I did add some extra padding on the inside of the enclosure, and I did get warned by that before I even did it. I knew that it was going to change the tuning somewhat, but I didn't think it was going to change it as much as it did. I actually think that the ports or the chambers are now tuned a lot lower on this end than what it was at first. I think it altered my middle band or my middle band frequency, which is just the differences in between the two here. So, say for instance, if this was 30 hertz and this was 60 hertz, or in this case, this was 60 hertz and this was 30 hertz, then your middle band would be like 40 hertz, because that's in the middle of 30 and 60 would be approximately 40, right? Because you got 45 would be your middle band, because then you would have 30, you would have 40, you would have 50, and then you would have 60. So in between 40 and 50, which is 45, would be your middle band. That's an easier way of finding that other than doing the math, right? Very simple math equation, very simple philosophy. So my middle band being 45 per se, that's what it's supposed to be. But we're going to put it, I don't know if you guys know or not, but we in ISD do have a tone generator built in. I know in my previous videos I've always used a mobile application, but however, we in ISD do have that built into its programming. So we're going to be using this today, because this is what the response curve is showing us now that it's supposed to be, based off of the specification of the plans that I use to construct the box. However, whenever you start adding things like acoustic foam and bracing and things of that nature, if you did not, you know, plan ahead for that displacement, then it's going to throw your tuning off. Your chambers are going to be tuned to something completely different from what it is in the graph here. So what we're going to do, we're going to start off with the middle band frequency, which is supposedly 40 hertz, and we're going to be moving on from there. 45 hertz, I'm sorry. Before I continue, I just want you guys to know that what we have powering the unit is going to be the Dayton Audio SPA250. If I can get this thing to focus here, the glare is killing me right now. All right, so yeah, we have the Dayton Audio SPA250. Again, this is the same plate amplifier featured in my previous videos. I just wanted to let you guys know, in case for those who are new, this is what I will be using to power the unit. I do have the frequency wide open, so it's at 180 hertz is what it let through, is the highest that it will go, so that's what I got it set on. And of course the gains are set pretty low. I mean, I'm in a garage. This is a six order band pass with approximately 3.5 cubic foot of volume. So this thing will shake down the house. I mean, I literally thought that I was going to break my windows at one point. So I'm not going to give this thing a whole lot of volume and make my neighbors mad at me. So this is just for a test. I'm doing this for you guys. Moving on. All right, as you guys can see right here, if you were to follow the mouse, this is the tone generator right here. If you click this, you would get whatever it is that you're trying to get. Right now, it's starting off at 1,000 hertz. Of course, we don't want that. So we're just going to click right here. So this is 20 hertz, 30 hertz, 40 hertz, and about 45 hertz should be our middle frequency band. So as you can see, well, I guess I got to get it dragged here. So that's approximately 45 hertz right here. I'm just going to hit generate. It should give you a prompt to say that, hey, check your volume. We're good on volume. Let's go. Now, according to this, it should be my middle band, because I do have it. Let me go to the box here. It's actually approximately 30 and 50 is what it was supposed to be tuned to. So approximately a 40 hertz is actually supposed to be my middle band right here. It's 40 hertz, but I know it's not tuned to that right now. So let's just look at what port is activated right now. And as you can see, that port right here has pretty much taken all of the tissue on the inside. So it's activated, and this is not activated over here at all. This is my 30 hertz port, and this is the 50 hertz port. This port here is completely activated, and this port is not. So let's now go. And as you guys know, this is supposed to be my middle band. So what does that mean in a sixth order? Your middle band is supposed to have both ports activated. At 50 hertz, this should be only activated with a little drop off from here, with just a little bit of activation over here, just a little activity, not a lot. Now, this is my 30 hertz port, but at 50 hertz, this would be fully activated, kind of like what it is now, okay? And at 40 hertz, which is the middle band, according to my programming, at 40 hertz, both ports will be activated. So you'll see a gradual transition from 50 hertz, 40 hertz, both ports will be activated. At 30 hertz, only this port will be activated. But as you guys can see, according to the programming, this port, what is supposed to be my middle band is not my middle band. In actuality, only this port is activated on 40 hertz, which is not a good sign. That let me know that this enclosure is not tuned at all correctly. And probably because of that, the padding that I have inside of this port here is throwing off my frequency response of this box. It seems to be tuned a lot lower. It's a whole lot lower than original. So we're gonna go and we're gonna see when exactly do this port becomes activated. So we're gonna decrease the frequency until this port right here becomes activated. So let's do that. I know you guys can't see that screen right now, but I'm just gonna drag it just so you guys can see. Right now, it's at, that's at 40 hertz right now. And I'm just gonna drag it over to 30 hertz and see what happens. So I'm grabbing it right now, and let's put it to 30 hertz. I'm slowly going over to 30 hertz. And right now is at 30 hertz. And it seems as though 30 hertz is my middle band now. So what does that mean? If 30 hertz is my middle band, what exactly does that mean? Let's keep going until the port over here is not activated at all. I'm doing it with a mouse in case you guys are wondering. So let's keep going until this port is not activated. And that'll give us an idea of what this port is tuned to. So this is at 30 hertz right now. Let's keep going. All right. Let's keep going. That's about 25 hertz. Let's keep going. All right. A lot of mechanical noises there. Let's keep going until we get some actual sound from it. Yeah, it's slapping pretty hard right there. Let's go back. It's slapping pretty hard right there. This one is actually still, it looks like it's activated, but it's really not. What's happening is that it does still need mechanical movement in order to activate this port to push this air here. It still does need some movement, and this chamber here is only 1/4 foot. This is 2.5/4 feet. So what is that at? So that's approximately 26 hertz. Wow. It's brought the tuning. Let me pause it. So it seems as though, and I hope I wasn't distorting so bad where you guys can't do it. I couldn't hear me while I was talking. I may have to do a voiceover. It seems as though that foam I put on the inside of this thing has brought the tuning down in the enclosure all the way to 26 hertz or less. It may be even 25 hertz. So I went from a tuning of 30 hertz to 25 hertz and on this chamber, and I'm still wondering what this chamber here is. As you can see, 40 hertz had this activated all by itself, and 30 hertz, both ports was pretty loud at 30 hertz. So I'm kind of, if I were to do the math, 30 hertz, both ports activated, 40 hertz, only this port activated. So that means that 30 hertz is the middle band, 40 hertz is this driver approximately, and this one is approximately 20 in the lower 20s. Wow, that's kind of amazing. That's, to me, it is. I mean, we can give another test of it, but to me, that's kind of interesting. But anyway, enough talk. Let's get another demo of this. Let me pause it. And again, this is the 26 hertz. So let's try to put it up to back to 40 hertz, back to 30 hertz, and we're gonna see if both ports are still as activated. Let me get here, generate. Okay, let's go 40. Hertz, 35 hertz, 38. Yeah, so it looks like definitely I've thrown the tuning of this off quite, you know, lower than what it was originally. But to be honest with you, I'm not upset with this. I'm not upset with this. It still sounds damn good for me. I am taking this out of my ride and I'm putting it in the house. So this is optimal tuning to me, in my opinion. It's optimal tuning for the home entertainment system that I'm going to be building for this. So I like it. I think that this is a good thing, actually. It gives me that that low-end response that I'm going to need during my movies. I mean, I'm slightly disappointed because of, you know, I didn't plan for it ahead of time, because I do plan on still playing music with this in the car. It sounds damn good, and it sounds damn good now, but I already know that my punchy bass, I'm gonna lose that, and that's why I have been losing my high-end notes, which is, you guys probably heard me state in a previous videos. But as of right now, that is it for this. I'm gonna be bringing you guys more of this right here as I build the system for it. But for right now, that's it. Let me know what you guys think in the comment sections below. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you dislike the video, by all means, give it a thumb down. This is a free country. And don't forget to like the video and share the video with anyone who you feel may get something out of this video. But until then, it's your boy D, and I'm out.